Yo, what is going on, guys? We're back in the Ferrari's Cryptic TNG, and you guys might have seen my stream the other day where when I was in the Ferrari trying to get stuff figured out. I think maybe I might have a better race setup. I don't think it is maybe as good in quality, but the race setup feels pretty decent. So we're gonna see what we can do. Hopefully our tires last longer than it did on Wednesday, and we're gonna see how it goes. We qualified in sixth position. Did a 57.8 or something. I think I've been a bit quicker than that. So going to see what it's like in the race, and hopefully our tires don't fall off. Starting on the outside again, which I'm not a big fan of. But I'm gonna see if we can get anything done. A great start. We're gonna keep our foot in though. Whoa. Jesus. Whoa. What has gone on? Absolute chaos, lads, in the first lap. I think we're lucky we didn't get a good start. I think we're up into third position right now. The Porsche way quicker than us down the straight. Was insane. I think I might have been Luke Addison and the Aston that got absolutely killed. Hopefully our tire pressures are decent as well. We are behind Alexander Kramowski. For those with a good memory, you might remember him from Project Cars. He was pretty aggressive. Pull it that way. We're going to try and keep the inputs as smooth as possible. That's the one corner on the circuit where I struggle to get the car slowed down. But we are slightly catching Kramowski in front. I'm being careful. Whenever I feel the car on the edge of grip, I'm trying not to put my foot on the accelerator so I'm not using up the tire, you know? braking slightly earlier for corners. Let's see how much we can make this tire last. Try to outlast the guys in front. Now with ACC, it's almost as if you have to sort of get all your inputs spot on when turning in. The gap is fluctuating a little bit. I'm definitely not all out pushing just yet. Might try to push it a little bit in this lap just to get a bit closer. Mask is all over the place at the moment. He's definitely using his tires. That's not good. Don't know what happened there. Leader was absolutely flying on the last lap. Thank you. I've got a feeling Kramowski's going to run out of tyres. Just as I said that. He's really sliding the car now. Stretching the gap to the cars behind. Try and get as close as possible. He does seem to struggle towards the end of the lap a little bit. There he goes again. He seems to be pushing it too hard into the corners. Either that or his rear tires are giving up. Let me get close enough to get a good slipstream. Stay close in this last sector. His rear tires are fighting him. But the Porsche still, look at the acceleration. The Ferrari acceleration is dog water. I just kept it tight this time. Last 10 minutes to start applying the pressure. There's gun in deep. The Porsche just got more straight line. I've got nothing on straight line and acceleration, so it's gonna have to be done in the braking zones. Whoops, that'll be one. We both got a slide on there. This is where you start to damage your tires when you're stuck behind somebody. You can visibly see his car just not gripping up. Literally just can't get the run. I can tell the guys behind must be struggling on tires because I've got so much more pace, it's just impossible to get past the guy. Look at his rear end. He's absolutely fighting that car. Oh, we need to get closer. Offline was well dirty. We did it. We got to watch for his run though. We need to escape because that Porsche is pretty quick down the straight. Let's go. Need to get away. He makes a mistake. I honestly think he's not changed his race setup from his quali setup, because if you have the speed to be at the front in quali, theoretically you should really be there in the race, but judging by the look of how his car was behaving, he's gone too aggressive on the toes and cambers and stuff, which is what happened to me on Wednesday. Look at the time he's already lost. Even the leaders down into the 59s now. Whoops. Never mind. Car definitely feels a lot better than it did the other day when the rear tires just literally gave up. I still think we could probably make this car a little more faster through the fast corners, I think. It's a little bit safe. But safe gives you a good platform to build off of. Definitely extending the gap to the cars behind, so I think the setup is pretty solid. turned in too late. Alright, and there we are. We're going to come home in second place, lads. And I will take it. I will take it considering where we started. Pretty good result on the podium, second position. Good fight for second place of Alessandro Kamalski. And to be fair to him, he was pretty clean, man. Left me room when I did get beside him. So, yeah, pretty happy with that, guys. And I would definitely say from now on, just get rid of the rear toe completely. I think you can still run negative toe on the front. How much you want to run is completely up to you. I would sort of tailor it down a lot to the track temp or air temperature. And I wouldn't really go above 3 in a race, to be honest. I wouldn't go above 3 toe in a race. Rear toe, I would pull it at the maximum on like -0.5. That's maximum. Anything more than that, I think you're going to start to struggle. But yeah, seemed to work. Definitely didn't have the tire fall off that I had the other day, and I'm pretty happy with that. Next up, I think I'm going to try the Bentley. So hopefully the Bentley is a half decent around Silverstone. Let's see. Anyway, guys, Crypto TMG, like and subscribe, hit the notification bell to catch my videos first, and peace.